Hello, my name is Manuel José López Morales. I am the SR2 of the team at 5G María Eslodescalcuri Action Project, and I am a PhD student at the Universidad Carlos III de Madrid in Spain. I am going to present you Massive MIMO systems with little or no channel state information. In classical communications, also called coherent, we need to acquire channel state information for the system to work. In this case, a transmitter sends a known signal, also called pilot, usually referred with P, that goes through a channel, and then some noise is added at the receiver. The received signal Y is processed to try to receive with the known pilot to try to estimate the channel. The problem is that if I am sending pilots, I am not sending information. In fact, this problem worsens in high mobility and/or low scenarios, because we either have to estimate the channel many times to track the channel variations, this is in the high mobility scenarios, or we have to estimate the channel many times to average the estimation in case of low scenarios. The problem is that if we have a high pilot density, then we have a high overhead and a low efficiency, which results in a low data rate. In this context, non-coherent communications arise. But what are non-coherent communications? As I said before, in coherent detection, we have to send a synchronized replica. We need a synchronized replica of the carrier at the receiver. Also, channel state information is needed, at least in the receiver. In non-coherent detection, no reference wave is used, differential detection is applied, no channel state information is needed at the receiver side, transmitted data can be estimated in the receiver without using channel state information, and the data may be differentially encoded. This is an example of the performance of a multi-user system with high channel variability. In this case, we can see two curves where the symbol error rate doesn't decrease much, which are coherent with phase noise or a nonlinear amplifier, and the two users move at the speed of 500 kilometers per hour. And then we have the non-coherent with phase noise or a nonlinear amplifier, which can see that increasing the SNR results in a decreasing symbol error rate. But we don't only have to choose between coherent and non-coherent. We can in fact combine them. Here there is an OFDM grid where, for instance, we can place in the yellow we have in K the subcarriers and in N the time slots. We have placed pilots in the yellow resource elements. And then we would have the classical coherent scheme. But we could add, instead of pilots, we could add non-coherent data in the yellow places. Then, with this non-coherent data, since we can extract the data without estimating the channel, so in this signal model we can see that from here we can estimate X. If X is correctly estimated, we can put it back in the received signal model. Then this would be equivalent to having a known pilot, to sending a known pilot, and then with this we can estimate the channel. In this case, most of the pilots can be replaced by non-coherent data. You can see that in this situation we have a hybrid scheme. So, in case the delay spread or the Doppler spread is very low, we would use the coherent scheme either with pilot symbol assisted modulation or superimposed training. And in case the Doppler spread is high, or the delay spread is high, we could go directly for the non-coherent scheme, but in between we could use the hybrid proposed scheme. This proposal is better explained in the paper Differential Data Aided Channel Estimation for Uplink Massive SIMO OFDM, which was published in the IEEE Open Journal of the Communication Society in 2020. Also, we can use artificial intelligence techniques for constellation design in non-coherent schemes. The problem is that the non-coherent scheme results in an intractable problem. then to design constellations, the best is to rely on artificial intelligence techniques. We published a paper named A Survey About Deep Learning for Constellation Design Communications in the CSNDSP in Porto 2020, and we are currently working in an extension of the results that are currently under submission to the Transactions and Communications. Some future ideas can be combined non-coherent with cell-free, design full deep learning-based receivers, or design a multi-user allocation strategy. The main goal of this research is to develop and improve the performance of massive MIMO systems using little or no CSI.